Yes, it's a privilege. Good afternoon to everyone. Radio Land is a privilege and a pleasure to be with you in studios today on Cool FM 103.3. Cool FM, the cool people, the cool songs. And you are listening to Sowers of the Gospel, aired every Sunday, comments at 3 and conclude at 4 with the followers of the Sowers of the Gospel. It's a radio program in Anguilla, at the Valley Anguilla on the north side. It's almost 30 years a program that God has sustained on air with our brother James and sister Mary and some other brothers. And we thank God for this longevity of this program that you aired on Cool FM on every Sunday. So we thank God for that. And we would like you to just bow your heads and close your eyes, please, with us as we always reverence the Most High God for being with us, sustaining this program for all over the years, and I'm being part of it as well. And we thank God for the many speakers and many preachers that he has given a word every on Sunday to Sunday to preach, to touch the hearts of believers in all over the world. So Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this broadcast, Lord God. We thank you for the people, Lord God, you ordain in this time, of this time, Father, on this program, to minister your word, the gospel, the true gospel of Jesus Christ that is in existence, O God. So we thank you for that, Father. We thank you, Lord God, for giving each and every one utterance through the power of your Holy Spirit to touch the hearts of men and women worldwide, Lord God. We listen to your gospel. It doesn't matter what particular group they affiliate with, Father, but we know it's your power, it's your Holy Spirit that brings salvation unto man, Father. Glory be to your name. So we thank you, Lord God, for touching the hearts of stone, Lord God. Turn them into a heart of flesh, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, your word will go forth with power, Lord God, in different countries, different shores, Lord God, and people, Lord God, will receive you, Father, in a timely, perilous time like this, Father. Not only this program, but every gospel program, every program, Lord God, that minister your gospel around the world, on Facebook, on all the radio station, every pastor, every minister, every church, Lord God, that speak about your goodness, the death and the resurrection of your son Jesus, because Jesus Christ is our only hope. So we pray, Lord God, our people, the people, those who are lost, those you have found already, Lord God, will continue to receive the word of your son Jesus, that he died on the cross for our sin. Father, we pray for the land of Anguilla. We pray for the government, Lord God, that you would continue, Lord God, could give them the unction to function, Lord God, to be able to use the resources of the land, Lord God, as is intended to be used, Father. We pray, Lord God, for every sector, Lord God, over this land. We pray for the nurses, the doctors, the security officers, everyone, Lord God, who get up in the morning, that you put breath in their nostrils, Lord God, and who go to their various works, Lord God, to do their works, Lord God. We know that the lazy man shall not eat, Father, but we know also that you create everyone for a purpose, Father. Even those who work, Lord God, on the sanitation trucks, we call them garbage trucks, we call them trash trucks, Father, but we know they sanitize the place, Father, and we pray for them that you would protect them, because this trash, Lord God, sometimes had a lot of toxic, Lord God, could destroy their bodies. Many men and women has lost their life just working on these trucks, Lord God, by ingesting and taking the sense of different form of garbage and different toxic, but we pray that you would protect them, even when they drive in the early morning on this wet road sometimes, Father, that you would protect these guys that take care of this trash, this garbage, Father God. We pray, Lord, for every security officer, even when we're in our bed sleeping, Lord God, the security officers, I'm not speaking about only the security, the policemen are part of our security teams as well, Father. We pray for each and every one of them, the prison officers, Lord God, we pray for them as well, Father. We pray for the nurses, the doctors, and the ministers of your word in every church, Father God. You will give them that authority, that power to function, that the authority that your son Jesus has given, that power, Lord God, that mandate to win souls and to pray for the people, Father. We thank you, Lord, for this land. We thank you for a thriving industry, tourism industry, Lord God, to keep it afloat, that our people of Anguilla will continue to breathe that breath of fresh air, Father. Glory be to your name. We pray that your network of blessing will continue to be over this, hover over this land of Anguilla, Father. Glory be to your name. And over the lands in the Caribbean, Dominica, and every land of the Caribbean, Father, touch them. Release angels, Father, because we need you in the Caribbean more than ever before. Because a lot of negatives, Lord God, we see on social media each and every day, on traffic, Lord God, in the society, young men, guns and everything, Father. It looks like, Lord God, the spirit of kin is taking over the lands in the Caribbean. And I'm speaking about this, when Cain kill Abel, Lord God, that spirit of jealousy. We pray that, Father God, destroy that spirit that is plaguing this land, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we already give you this radio program already, Father. We thank you for having it. We thank you for management and staff, Bevan Brooks. We thank you for Brother Lee One Production, Lord God. We thank you for strengthening his physical body, mentally, emotionally, supernaturally, Father God. Glory be to your name. And we command and we pray, Lord God, we command wherever he is right now, Father God, we command his body. We're not asking, but we command his body to function the way that you created it at its first place, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father. And we pray that this radio, Lord God, not only this program, this radio will continue to rise, Father, in the name of Jesus. So, Father, we thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. I'm so happy to be in this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Father, we pray for our viewers on Facebook. We pray for our listeners on the radio as well in Anguilla, and those who are listening to us in every form of social media. We thank God for having our people. It's because of them we're still here, Father, with the encouragement, with the prayers from our loved ones all around the place. So, Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It's so nice to be here with you today. Our brother Michael Bevan, it's so good. Sorry, I always say Michael Fleming. Sorry, brother Michael Fleming. Our brother Michael Fleming, our brother James, and our sister Tara, and we miss our sister Mary. So we thank each and every one of them, because we sharpen each other every time we see only just a smile to each other. It gives us that drive in us, you know, to know that we are happy. We are the child of the living God, and the Spirit of God dwelling in us. Because it's not easy to smile and laugh in the time we are living. We are living in the last days, a days full of perilous, days full of depression or oppression. It's a high percentage of people being depressed, and a lot of the lands in the world are oppressed, and it's difficult to see a smile on somebody's face. When you see a smile on somebody's face, it is rare. Oh, glory be to God. But we know when somebody smiles, it is something that is within him. It's the power of the Holy Spirit of God. Glory be to your name. Would cause you to smile and laugh on every difficulty. And sometimes it doesn't matter what we go through. But when you have the Spirit of Christ in you, hallelujah, you'll rise above that situation that designed to destroy you. There are situations, you know, as believers, that are designed, that been orchestrated by the enemy to cause you to be unhappy, to cause you to be sad, to cause you to be crushed. But glory be to your name. Greater is he that is in us, that is he that is in the world. Hallelujah. I can boast in the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is the power and the truth of Jesus. Hallelujah. So you in Radio Land and you on Facebook, I say pleasant good afternoon to each and every one of you on Facebook this afternoon. And as you continue to type and say you are here, and the island you are representing, we'll continue to big you up, hail you up, and mention your name, and believe God for you as well. And on Radio Land, we have our brother, Leonard Hodge in Island Harbor. How are you doing, my brother? We are so happy to have you every Sunday, and you acknowledge that you've been here with us. And we want to say, Leonard Hodge, Island Harbor, we know sometimes you tune in, brother, and thank you for listening to us, and thank you for encouraging us. And this is the reason why God have us doing these things, so people like you will listen, and wherever we make mistakes, you will meet us on the street and say yes, and then you'll encourage and sharpen. That's what God creates. We're not an island by ourselves. Oh, glory be to your name. I'm speaking about our physical being. We're not only an island, because God created us to serve each other. So thank you, our brother Leonard Hodge in Island Harbor. Hallelujah. And at this time we have some other brothers, our brother James, we're gonna take him in so that we could exalt you or encourage you as a listen. Our sister Martha Laura on Facebook in Dominica, Vincentia, Adrian, and all the rest, Jennifer Giroud del Dong here in Dominica, we thank God for having each and every one of you. Flella was in the United States, Jeff Lesterad in the United States as well, and Lucy Gilbert up there in Aruba, we thank God for you and those of you in London, United Kingdom, and the USA, many, oh, a lot of names too numerous to mention, and on Radio Land, oh, plenty of you as well. Sometimes we even forget the names, and Louis Richette and Safety Steps, and Nurse Boy down in the valley, and washing cars, and we thank you for that shining the cars. Oh, glory be to your name. And at this time, we're gonna bring you our brother to exalt you, and his name is the committed one, Brother James Brooks. Take it away, brother.
Pleasant good evening, good afternoon, radio listeners on Facebook. We thank God for having you tune in to this broadcast this Sunday, and I pray that you will surrender to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, before time changes into eternity in those in radio land who are tuned into this radio broadcast, Souls of the Gospel, that comes your way this Sunday. We pray that you will give your life to Christ before time changes into eternity, because these are the last days that we are living in, and without a shadow of a doubt, we have to arm ourselves in the things of God, because when everything is done and said, only that be done for God will last. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared unto all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, that we shall live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope and glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. It's a pleasure to be in the midst of Brother Lawrence, Brother Michael Fleming, and Sister Tara, where we are here as the saints of God, as the body of Christ, to proclaim the good news to the four corners of the earth. And I will admonish for at least 2 or 3 minutes on Jesus, the miracle worker. And the scripture reading that I will be sharing today, admonishing on, is from St. Luke chapter 5, reading from verse 1 to 9, which talks about a miraculous catch of fish, as it reads. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw 2 ships standing by the lake, but the fishers of men were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon, and prayed him that he will thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep, and let down your net for the drought. And Simon answered, said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night, and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down thy net. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fish, and their nets brake, and they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ships, and they shall come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. Conclusion, for he was astonished at all that were with him, and at the drought of the fish which they had taken. Amen. And that's why I will admonish this afternoon, Jesus, the miracle worker. We know Jesus does miracles. He did it years ago, and he still can do miracles today, because he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. He don't change at all. He's a miracle, miraculous, working, powerful God. As Peter did not want to let down his net, but he said, nevertheless, and he threw down his net, and there was a great catch of fish. And these was fishers of men who toiled the sea all day and was catching nothing. But because of obedience, they catch a great multitude of fish. And I'm saying this afternoon, whoever you are this afternoon, whatever you're going through this afternoon, your problems in these tough and perilous times that you are faced with, whatever illness in your body, Jesus is a miracle working, healing, powerful God. We know when he turns the water into wine, they said unto Mary said, nevertheless, whatever he say, do it, because he's the master. They bring water, it turns into wine, and when they drink, they was drunk. But when Jesus turned the water into the wine, the governors never thought of this before. And I'm saying, if Jesus could turn water into wine, even Lazarus, who was in the tomb 4 days and already being stinked, Jesus called him by name and said, come forth.
Lazarus, dead man, walking out of a tomb. I'm saying this afternoon, Jesus is a miracle working powerful God. If you're in the hospital this afternoon, whatever you're diagnosed with in your bodies, whatever you're faced with, there is nothing too hard for God to do. With man, all things are impossible, but with God, all things are possible. God could do the things that you could never comprehend in your own natural capacity, but when you learn to trust in God and lean on God, whatever the circumstances or the situations or the pains or the sorrows or the temptation or the affliction, whatever bombarding you this afternoon, God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think of, according to the powers that work it in us. Don't trust in Him. As I say, don't put God for granted. God could do the impossible things. That's why He said in closing, in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6, that familiar passage, where He said, "Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path." Whatever in your body, whatever illness you are facing with, don't worry. Throw everything on God, and God will see you through. Amen. God.
Yes, well said. Well said, Brother James, and we thank God for that. Yes, Brother James, well said, and we thank God for this encouraging word which came forth with power. And we're making way to bring our sister Tara to bless you with whatever that God placed on her, whether it's a song or testimony or exhortation. And at this time, we're going to bring you our sister Tara. Sister Tara.
Afternoon, radio listeners. Today I just want to give you a scripture verse to encourage you a bit. It's taken from Mark chapter 11, verse 24. It says, "Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when you pray and believe, ye shall receive them, and ye shall have them." So that scripture there is telling us that, you know, that anything that we pray for, that we desire, we will receive it once we believe. So even as Christian people, we have to, when we pray, we have to believe, you know, that God gonna answer our prayer. Because the scriptures, you know, clearly says that once, you know, you desire something and you pray for it and you believe, you know, you should have it.
Amen.
And it's the word of God. God is not a man that he will lie. His words are true. So, you know, we just have to stand on that word, and that whatever we pray, whatever we desire, and we pray that God would answer.
Amen.
So this afternoon I'm going to sing for you. We wait on you. We wait on you. We wait on you. We wait on you.
Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory, come. Shekinah glory, come. Release the goodness of your spirit. Shekinah glory, come. Shekinah glory, come. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, glory come now, Shekinah glory. Here we are standing in your presence, here we are standing in your presence. Shekinah glory come now, Shekinah glory. I'm such a over, couldn't find nobody. I look high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody's greater, nobody's greater, nobody's greater than you. I search all over, I couldn't find nobody. I searched high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody's greater, nobody's greater, nobody's greater than you. Nobody's greater, nobody's greater, 'cause nobody greater than you.
Amen. Amen, 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 amen. Sister Tara, Sister Tara does bless us. Nobody's greater than you. Hallelujah. Sharon Benjamin, it's nice to have you, my sister in Atlanta. We're so happy to have you. Every Sunday you comment on our live, and we thank God for you, our sister Sharon Benjamin, up there in the United States of Atlanta. So we thank you, my sister, for continuing to pray for us and viewing us on Facebook every Sunday and commenting, showing us that you are here. And we say thank you for that. And at this time, I'm gonna play you a song especially for you, my sister. Sister Sharon Benjamin, I'm gonna play you the old Rugged Cross.
And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best, for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross, at last I'll lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Rugged cross, I will ever be true. Its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I'll lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross.
Yes, the old rugged cross. Yes, hallelujah, the old rugged cross. I will exchange some of these for a cross, hallelujah. And it's that cross that brings us salvation. And had not been for the death of Jesus Christ on that cross, he became a curse, hallelujah, so that you and I can obtain salvation by allowing him, by laying down his life so that they could nail him to a cross. And the scripture said, and I quote that many times, there is no greater love than this, for man to sacrifice his life for his friend. Hallelujah. Isn't that wonderful? For your father to send you on a mission and know that you have to go through that painful death on the cross, for that man would be saved, that man would receive salvation. And you said, oh, yes. You go through it, though it was painful, but you did it for us, and you say, thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross. Sister Tara sing a wonderful song, Nobody's Greater. Who can be greater than Jesus when you could be allow yourself to be nailed, to be beaten, pass vinegar and everything in your mouth, and going through all this thing? Tina Payne, I say pleasant good afternoon to you, Tina Payne, down there in Antigua. It's so nice to have you, and I'm commenting on the live. We thank God for you guys. Good afternoon, and then to Sister Martha and Judith Gegwa. Oh, hallelujah! Thanks for having you, my sister, down there in Saint Martin, Sakafet Kai Pasil. Bon après-midi pour tout le monde, Saint Martin. Everybody in Saint Martin, good afternoon to you. Judith Gregor in Saint Martin, Tina Payne in Antigua, and Sharon Benjamin up there in Atlanta. We're so happy to have each and every one of you. You are so important to us. We're so happy to have you on every program, that when you guys acknowledge that you guys are here, it makes us feel good, and it makes us feel nice to know that we have company and we have people acknowledging us. We have people listening to us everywhere in Antigua, in London, and we say thank God for blessing you, Tina Payne, down there, and your family and your children. We pray that God will continue to bless you and your family and your children, and sustain you in the land of Antigua. Oh, bless God to have all you today. And without further ado, we have a minister in the house by the name of our brother Michael Fleming. This man always have a smile, and he knows about his word, and at this time he's going to present to you the word of Jesus Christ. And we're going to open your mic, brother Michael Fleming, and just deliver your word, because people listen to you I should say regionally, internationally, and I don't want to say worldwide yet, but glory be to God. So brother Michael, take it away, brother.
Thank you so much, Brother Lawrence. God bless you. It is good to have G in the house and Sister Tara. You know, after listening to you with that powerful prayer, you know, I can really tell that you are a man of God. When you prayed for our people, the way you prayed, and it reminded me, like yesterday, we decided to close up the church building and go into the villages, and we started from West End and going into the different villages and praying, and pray for a number of people and for the communities. So I thank God for you and for the prayer that you offered for everyone just earlier. And we give God praise and thanks for that powerful prayer. And Brother James talking about Jesus, the miracle walking Savior, our Lord and Savior, is also part of this message this afternoon. And Sister Tara hit it right on the head, because this message this afternoon is about faith, believing. And Sister Tara really hit it on the head, because one of my scriptures is Mark 9:23. Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. You know, the problem that we have in our world today is that people are not believers. They don't believe. And that's the problem. And that's why I want to bring this message to you this afternoon. And I hope that there may be somebody listening and that can believe with all their heart, so that they can get the answers to their prayers. And that's exactly what Sister Tara mentioned. Let us pray. Father in heaven, I want to thank you for your presence of your Holy Spirit, thus leading thus far, Lord. We thank you for the blessings we have already received through the word and through the song. Father, I thank you for everyone who part of this worship experience this afternoon, whether on radio or Facebook, however they're listening, dear Father, I ask a very special blessing upon them, and I pray that they'll find faith in you this afternoon, and they'll continue in the faith as well, and that their faith may continue to grow exceedingly. And Lord, that we all will go from strength to strength as we continue to trust you, who is the author and finisher of our faith. So bless your word to my heart again, Lord, and to your listeners. I ask it with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. It was just such a joy to be here again to minister to us. Brothers and sisters, the message this afternoon is centered around believing. You know, a lot of people tend to say that they don't have faith. But I want to share with us from the scriptures, and I want you to get a pen or a pencil and write these passages of scripture down so that you can go back over them and see what God has in his word that assures us that we have faith. And all we need to do is to exercise that faith so that we can get the answers to our prayers. As Sister Tara also mentioned that. So brothers and sisters, faith is not the absence of questioning. It is the presence of action in the midst of those questions that you and I have at times. So faith is not the absence of questioning. It is the presence of action in the midst of those questions. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 4 and 5, I want to read that for you. Not St. John, but 1 John, which is closer to the book of Revelation. And it reads, "For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith." Verse 5 states, "Who is he that overcometh the world? But he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God." Faith is believing. And too many people tend to believe that they do not have faith. But let's see what the Bible tells us in Romans chapter 12 and verse 3. In Romans chapter 12 and verse 3, the Bible says, "For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God had dealt to every man the measure of faith." So brothers and sisters, we are without excuse. Every single human being. When the Bible says God had dealt to every man a measure of faith, it means humankind. Every single human being. God has given us a measure of faith. And why would God give every man a measure of faith? You see, the Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6, "Without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him." So without faith, it is impossible to please God. So God wants us to please him. And therefore, he has given us a measure of faith. So we all have faith. Because if we didn't have it, we cannot please God. And then we're going to see in a few minutes that we need to believe. Faith is believing. And if we pray and we do not believe, we will not receive. A lot of times we pray hoping. Brothers and sisters, the Bible didn't tell us to pray and hope to receive. The Bible said, "Pray and believe that you have received and you shall have it." Our faith must be in Christ to receive what we ask for. Not in things or not in people, but in Christ. Our faith is in Christ. He is the author of our faith. And he's also the finisher. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, and verse 57, the Bible tells us, "Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord." And now listen to these passages of scripture, brothers and sisters. In Mark 9:23, Jesus said unto him, "If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth," which is faith. And the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 2:5, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. That's where our faith is. James chapter 1 and verse 6 says, ask in faith, not wavering, for he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind toss. So when the Bible says ask in faith, it means believe. 2 Corinthians 5, 7, for we walk by faith and not by sight. There's a story in the book of Mark, and I'm going to turn to that in a few minutes for you. Mark chapter 9, so keep your finger near to turn there. But in Mark 5, 36, the Bible tells us, as soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he said unto the ruler of the synagogue, be not afraid, only believe. So brothers and sisters, the problem is with us. Do we believe this afternoon? We have to believe. The Bible tells us in John chapter 1 and verse 12, as many as receive him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to them that do what? Believe on his name. So do we believe this afternoon? The Bible tells us in Mark 16, 16, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, and he that believeth not is damned. So the brothers and sisters, we must believe. Jesus said to Nicodemus, you must be born again. And if we want to be saved, we must believe. Because it's the only way to be saved. The Bible tells us in Romans 10:9, that if thou shalt confess to them, O the Lord Jesus, and shall believe where? In thine heart, that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Here again we got the word believe, which is faith. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall do what? Believe in thine heart that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Brothers and sisters, there is no other way out for us than to believe. The Bible tells us, if thou canst believe, all things are possible. Many people struggle with their faith at different times in their lives. Some of the most committed and godly leaders have struggled with doubts, just like everyone else. The very essence of faith is to believe in that which we cannot see. Hebrews chapter 11 speaks about many persons, including Rahab the harlot. As a result of believing, she will be saved. As physical beings, we tend to put faith in what we experience with our senses. Spiritual realities are not tangible and must be experienced outside our senses. So when that which is tangible and visible seems overwhelming, doubts can shroud that which is invisible. Brothers and sisters, to the Christian's claim, to those of us who claim that the Bible is God's inspired word. So, when struggling with faith, it is vital to define the object and reasonableness of the faith. Our faith claims are not equal, but before we can be secure in our faith, we must answer the question, my faith is in what? Is it in a person? It is in the thing that I want? Or is it in Jesus? Many hold to the idea of having faith in faith. Faith itself is seen as the object rather than God himself. The biblical purpose for faith is to bring us into the presence of God. Hebrews 11, 6. Because it says without faith, it is impossible to please God. Because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. We can only find him, and the Bible tells us, when we come to him through faith in his son. In John 14, 6, Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Look at Jeremiah 29, 13. You shall seek me and find me when you shall seek me with all your heart. So you must believe in your heart. You must seek God with all your heart. God does not bless half-hearted attempts to know him. He desires that we pursue him with a passion, the same way he pursues us. And in 1 John 4:19, it tells us how much God and how God pursues us. The Bible tells us we love him because he first loved us. That's why we love him. It is God coming after us, pursuing us. What is he pursuing us for? To punish us? To condemn us to hell? No, God is pursuing us to rescue us, to save us. And it is he's coming after us with much love and compassion and tenderness and care for us. And brothers and sisters, because of God's love for us, we love him. However, God understands our inability to exercise the faith we need at times. In Mark chapter 9 and verse 24, there's a beautiful story there in Mark chapter 9 and verse 24. But I want to pick up from verse 17 in Mark chapter 9. One of the multitude answered and said, Master, I have brought unto thee my son, which... Let me go over that. And one of the multitude answered and said, Master, I have brought unto thee my son, which had a dumb spirit. And whithersoever he taketh him, he teareth him, and foameth, and gnasheth with his teeth, and pineth away. And I spake to thy disciples, and they should cast him out, and they could not. In verse 19, Jesus says, O faithless generation, lack of faith. But then Jesus asked him, how long, in verse 21, that this thing was happening to your son? And he said, from a child. In verse 23, Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. So here, brothers and sisters, we come again. This man needed answer to his prayer, his concern for his child who had a dumb spirit. And Jesus tell him, if he can believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Amen. And look what Jesus said in verse 24. And straightway the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe, help thou my unbelief. I believe, but I also have unbelief. Brothers and sisters, the point is, a man admitted to Jesus that he wanted help with his unbelief. Jesus did not rebuke the man, but healed the man's child anyway because of his faith. He honored the man's desire to grow in faith and was pleased that he, Jesus, was the object of that faith. So if we have the desire to believe that the Bible teaches, then we have the right foundation for continuing to fight the good fight of faith. God has given us countless evidences of his existence and character. Look at Psalms 19:1, Luke 19. And Jesus fulfilled all these scriptures so that it is important for us to know that if we truly believe in God, things will happen for us, brothers and sisters. Not hoping to, but believe that God, if God says something, he will do it. And if it is spoken, it will come to pass.
Yes.
Amen. God leaves the blessings up to us, brothers and sisters. We all have the evidences we need, but God leaves the believing up to us. The evidence is clear. All we need to do is to believe. And faith is believing. It can be encouraging to remember that when we struggle with faith, we are in good company. Elijah, the prophet, experienced such a struggle. One of the greatest prophets of all time had just called down fire from heaven, killed over 400 false prophets, and outrun King Ahab's chariot. Running, you know. A feat that would have been the envy of the Olympic gold medalists. And you can find this story in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 36, 18:36, and you can read from verse 38 to 46. Can you imagine that a man or running King Ahab chariot, a chariot of horses. You know how fast a horse is? And this man outrun them. Yet the next chapter, 1 Kings 19, finds Elijah hiding in a cave, depressed and asking for death. After all those miracles, he gave in to fear and doubt because a wicked woman hated him. Jezebel decided that she was going to kill him. Brothers and sisters, during times of stress and exhaustion, we can easily forget all that God has done for us. Yes, it is possible, but I want to tell you this afternoon, don't give up on God. Continue to believe. John the Baptist was another who struggled with faith. So I can understand that some of us may struggle with faith, but I'm here to encourage and let you know this afternoon, you don't have to struggle anymore. John the Baptist struggled with faith when he was at his lowest point in life. Jesus had called John the greatest prophet in Matthew 11:11. John had been selected by God before birth to be the forerunner of the Messiah. He was faithful to that calling all of his life. Look at Mark chapter 1 verse 48. Yet even John, after being imprisoned and sentenced to die, struggled with doubts about Jesus' identity. He sent messengers to ask Jesus if he was truly the one sent from God. And Jesus did not rebuke John in his weakness, but instead sent him a message that only a student of the scriptures as John was, brothers and sisters, would recognize. And Jesus actually quoted from Isaiah 61 in that message that he sent to John. Brothers and sisters, if you go through the book of Hebrews chapter 11, you will see that there are many heroes of faith there in the book of Hebrews chapter 11. God is patient with us when we desire to believe. When we experience times of doubt, we must immerse ourselves in truth. We can boost our faith by reading the accounts of those who exercise faith in God. Brothers and sisters, when we read the Word, the Holy Spirit is there because the Word of God is imbued with power. The greatest power to overcome doubt comes from the Holy Spirit Himself, who bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. We can cry out as the man cried out to Jesus, "I believe, Lord, help my unbelief." And we can expect Him to answer. I don't know what you're going through this afternoon, brothers and sisters. I don't know what mountains you are faced with. But I remember in this song that speaks about life is easy when you're up on the mountain. And you got peace of mind like you had never known. But then things change when you're down in the valley. But the songwriter put these words in him. He said, even when you're down in the valley, don't lose faith. For because you're never, ever alone. God is with you. And when God says, I will be with you, I will never leave you nor forsake you, we need to believe it. Because the God on the mountain is the same God in the valley. And when things go wrong, the Bible tells us that He'll make them right. And even the God in the good times, brothers and sisters, is still the same God when we are going through bad times. The God of the day is still God in the night. So brothers and sisters, when it looks all dark and gloomy for you, you need to believe in God still. Don't stop believing in God because you're going through a crisis, because you have lost a loved one. Even this afternoon, I was in the office there going over this message this afternoon, and my wife came in crying. And I said, what happened? And she said, one of my family members I heard just died. That's Winston Proctor. And you know, yesterday while we ended up after praying in the different villages right in the valley, outside the NCBA Bank by the Rootwell Auditorium, he came up there, he embraced my wife, kissed her, and then sat down and listened to what was going on in the message. And then afterwards, he lied down on the eastern side of the gazebo, right there, like as though he went to sleep. And now we heard He was found on the park dead. That is sad. That is very painful. And right now there are persons who are mourning and grieving. But don't lose hope, because the Bible tells us that God is a God of comfort, and he'll comfort those who are mourn, who will mourn. So we talk of faith way up on the mountain. And talk at times comes easy when life is really at its best. But now down in the valleys of trials and temptation, there's where your faith is really put to the test, brothers and sisters. Like when we have lost a loved one, when we have someone in the hospital who is sick, dying from cancer or some other terminal disease, and we have been praying and asking God to do something. But we need to pray in faith, believing, and even and pray that God's will be done. Because when God's will is done, it is the best thing that can happen for anybody. So even at times, Christians die and doesn't get the answers that they ask for in their prayers. But they get a better answer because they'll be in the first resurrection. So that is best of all. So even if God allow us to die, all things work together for good to those of us who believe and who are called according to his purpose. So brothers and sisters, when we are down in the valley of the trials and temptation, and our faith is put to the test, don't give up, don't give in. The same God who was with you before is still with you even right now. And the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians 13, he will not put more on us than what we can bear, but will every trial and tribulation and temptation make a way of escape that we'll be able to bear. Because the God on the mountain is the God in the valley. And when things go wrong, he'll make them right. And the God in the good times, as I said, is the same God in the bad times. The God of the day is still the God in the night. So brothers and sisters, we can trust him. We can believe. And as my brother mentioned in Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding, and all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. So when the Bible says trust in the Lord, it means believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Trusting is believing. Believing is faith. Faith is believing. And I conclude by telling you, brothers and sisters, I believe that only those who believe obey, and those who obey are people who believe. Because when Jesus said to do something, when we obey him and do it, we will receive answers because we believe the word. So brothers and sisters, I want to encourage us this afternoon in closing to believe the word of God. Amen. There is no other way out for us than to believe. The Bible says he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. And if we shall confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God had raised him from the dead, we shall be saved. Do you want to be saved this afternoon, brothers and sisters? Do you want answers to your prayer? Then believe the word of God. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and these things will happen to you. This is the work of God. John chapter 6 and verse 29. Jesus answered and said unto them, this is the work of God, that ye believe on him whom he hath sent. Do you believe this afternoon? Again, John 11:40, final verse of the day. Jesus said unto her, said I not unto thee, that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? Brothers and sisters, what about us this afternoon? Do we want to see the glory of God? Do we want to be saved? Then we have to believe. May God bless us as we purpose in our hearts that from today on, we will really trust God with all our heart and believe the word of God. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Michael. Thank you, Brother Michael. It was so powerful. That's a powerful message. I endorse this message, Brother Michael. It went off with power. And it is impossible without faith. It is impossible to please God without faith. And faith is the evidence of things hoped for. Faith is the evidence of things not seen and the substance of things hoped for. So without faith, that you just cannot please God. And that's a powerful message. And I believe that is the message that God have in this season, in this hour, in this time. Because my scripture reading, I have it mapped up to read. It is in James chapter 2 and 15 to 30. I will not read it because of time. But it speaks about faith, and it speaks about the harlot. The harlot received the servant of God because of faith. And the Bible said that righteousness was imputed on Abraham because of faith. Because it took him faith to sacrifice his son Isaac. And that's what I was going to read in James, but because of time, I did not read the scripture reading. But here comes Brother Michael, bombarded the airways with faith. And Brother Michael, also powerful, and he'd been endorsed by your cousin up in Atlanta, your cousin Sharon Benjamin. Sharon Benjamin said, that is so powerful. And Brother Michael is my cousin. I don't know if you know her, Brother Michael. And that was a powerful message. Tina Payne, it's so nice to have you in Antigua. That's one of our family members. I have not seen her for years. Thank you for endorsing this message as well. And Judith Gregor down in St. Martin, Martha Laura, each and every one of you message us, acknowledge that you're here on Facebook, on Radio Land, or Brother Dong at let me not forget his name. I want to make sure I have it right this time. Or Brother Leonard Hodge in Island Harbor on the radio station. Our time is going so quick and we're just trying to wrap it up. But if you're confused on who you're listening to, you're listening to Sowers of the Gospel. It's on Cool FM, the cool people, the cool song, the cool vibes in Angola, on the north side and in the valley. And I'm always saying to you on Radio Land, on Facebook, Angola is a beautiful country with a lot of beaches, white sand beaches, a lot of beautiful hotels with a lot of variety of very good food. And you need to come to Angola to visit the shores of Anguilla. And I tell you, Anguilla is one of the Leeward Island territories, and it is good. So very close to St. Martin. It's a boat ride, about 20-25 minutes boat ride from St. Martin, and you're right here in Anguilla. And you a lot of guest houses, a lot of five-star resorts in Anguilla, whiteside beaches, as I say, white sand beaches. And you cannot go wrong in Anguilla. You could spin through Anguilla in the week for about two times in the week. And I would admonish you to visit the island of Anguilla on your vacation. It's a place that is cool and tranquilly and quiet, where you could go to the beaches. There is not very much noise here, and our crime is very low crime rate in Anguilla, so you'll have a peaceful time by visiting the shore of Anguilla. And we say thank you to everyone on Radio Land. We're so happy to have Brother Michael today with the powerful message. And as I say, we accept our sympathy to you, Brother Michael, on the passing of your family. And we know death is inevitable, and it's so hard to know that people have to go through death. But as we see, death is cannot be, it's inevitable, it's a must. But we know the Bible says, as your soul prosper, so shall you be in good health. And your soul can only prosper when your faith begin to rise up in Jesus Christ, when you begin to read the word and understand, and your faith, you become to grow in faith, your soul begins to prosper, and you will grow in health. And remember, it is scriptural. As your soul prosper, so you'll grow in health. And your soul can only prosper when you have faith in Jesus Christ. And you study, the more faith that you have, is more your soul prosper, and the longer that you live, because the Bible says is risk on 10 and by the reason of strength. So you could still live 90 years and 100 plus years, 80 years, based on science. Life expectancy is much higher than it was before, in spite of all the death. I'm just here to encourage you, because it's a gift from God. And the Bible says, a gift from God, hallelujah, it addeth no sorrow to it. Whenever you receive a gift from God, but sometimes we tap into the wrong realm, where it brings sickness to our bodies. But when we tap, as our soul prosper in God, so shall we be in good health. So we want to thank you for every viewer and every listener. Brother Michael, it's so nice to have you as always. Brother James and Sister Tara. And we say big up to Sister Mary up there in St. Kitts and Nevis. And we come to a conclusion of another program, another broadcast. We don't want to close today, because I can feel an atmosphere in this place, in the studio today, and we don't feel like leaving. But you know that we have a program and we have time.
and then we have to leave. And we conclude this program. And as I say, this program is every Sunday. It's Sowers of the Gospel on 103.3 on Cool FM. The cool people, the cool song, the cool vibes. And if you want the radio to listen to on Facebook in Anguilla, tap into this radio program, Cool FM. We have different programs during the week. And on Saturdays, we have the mayor shows, the group of Anguilla living in USA. And we have many other programs. We have one with Brother Ali, and I can't remember exact day, but he give you all the histories of Anguilla, and I learned some stuff from him as a non-native of Anguilla. The first doctor in Anguilla is one of the Hodges, I think. I can't remember the name, but that was in, oh boy, that's a long time ago. So that is just so you show you that you need to know the history of your land, from the struggles and everything that your land go through. And I'm listening to that history from Ali during the week. There's so a lot of programs on Cool FM, so you got to listen. But stay tuned to Voice of Salvation by Pastor Brooks and Company, followed by Kingdom Message with Brother Ashton Brooks. And later down, don't touch the dial. Stay connected to the spot that you got, because you have that Afro-Caribbean gospel show with Lady Joy, and on Wednesdays by Ali. Yes, on Wednesdays by Brother Ali, with that program he has with the history and things about Anguilla. So listen to our brother Ali, a lot of information. And as I say, we're closing at this time with Voice of Salvation.
Jesus, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.